I'm thinking this will be a quick one today, so let's jump into it. While I'm building this scene up in the background, I want to talk about a few different types of movement. So there's two main ones. There's teleportation, which is usually the intro type of movement for VR users because it doesn't cause motion sickness. And teleportation is a good alternative option if your game requires a continuous movement like in a first-person shooter where your character is actually gliding around, because users will not feel like they're moving, but then their peripheral vision tells them they're moving and that's what causes the motion sickness. It does require a user to be in VR and use that for several days or weeks to get used to that kind of movement. So a lot of players won't even play a game if there's not a teleportation option. So just keep that in mind when you're developing your game. Today we're going to talk about continuous movement because it's the easiest and also the most likely to be used in your game. So let's jump into it. First, we're going to go ahead and do all the setup for standard VR stuff. So if you haven't seen my intro to VR video, check that one out and that will walk you through the steps to actually getting all this set up. Installing OpenXR plugin will cause our application to restart because it's going to go back behind the scenes and change the input system from the old system to the new system. And we also want the XR Interaction Toolkit. And inside the XR Interaction Toolkit, make sure to grab the default input action sample unless you want to set all of the controls up by hand. And with that done, we go back to here and we select OpenXR, fix all. There we go. Now, before we add the XR rig to our scene, we're going to go into the XR Interaction Toolkit. So from assets, go to samples, XR Interaction Toolkit, the whatever package it is. And then inside of here, you're going to click on each one of these presets and add it to your action-based controller or the snap turn provider, move provider, all of those. From here, we can now right click inside of the hierarchy, add an XR room scale rig action-based. And I'm going to reset that to 0 and move it to where I want it in the scene. In order to get this to move, we need to add a few things to the XR rig. So first we're going to add a input action manager. Inside of the action assets for this component, we're going to drag in this XRI default actions. Make sure there's only one in here. Inside the hierarchy, click on the XR rig, right click, go to XR, and then we're going to add a action-based locomotion system. And this is going to come preset with a locomotion system script, which we would need to set the XR rig. It's going to have a teleportation provider and a snap turn provider. We're not doing teleportation today, so I'm going to right click on this and remove it. The snap turn is super easy to set up. It actually already is set up. It comes preset. If you have added these presets, it'll come preset with the actions already set up, and you just need to uncheck the hand that you're not going to be using. Usually, snap turns are performed on your right hand, so we're going to uncheck the left hand action. That way you can only perform the action with your right hand. And if you wanted this to be a continuous turn instead, all you have to do is add a component, and then we're going to go to XR, locomotion, and select the continuous turn provider, action-based. Make sure the locomotion system script is set, and then again, use the hand, and you'll have to disable the snap turn provider or remove it completely. And now you can very easily switch back and forth between the snap turn and continuous turn just by checking or unchecking one of these. Also inside of the snap turn provider, you can adjust how many degrees your character will get adjusted every time you bump the thumbstick. And also debounce time is essentially a delay between when you just performed a snap turn to when you can perform another one. Prevents you from accidentally double hitting it or something like that. Now let's set up the movement. We already removed the teleportation provider. We're going to go into XR, locomotion, and add a continuous move provider action-based. Make sure to set the locomotion system, and motion is usually performed with the left hand, so we're gonna uncheck the right hand motion. Also, you can adjust the move speed, and you can set when gravity is performed. So I'm going to go ahead and set it to immediately. Now, two more components we need to add before this will actually work. Go back up to your XR rig. We're going to add a character microcontroller. And this is a little collision box. I'm gonna set this up to 1, so it is 2 meters high. You can adjust the radius to be smaller if you want. And we're also going to add a character controller driver. Make sure to set the locomotion system for this. And in here you can set the minimum height and the maximum height that your character can become. And this will automatically adjust from the floor to the camera height for the head mounted display. I'm gonna split my screen so that you guys can see what actually happens when I try this out. One thing I noticed right off the bat is that only one controller is being tracked. So the other controller, you see there's no laser coming off of it. And I've noticed this for the last couple of versions of this OpenXR, it hasn't set the input actions for the right-hand controller correctly. See in here, all of the presets are set to the left hand, even though this is the right-hand controller. So real quick, I'm gonna go in here and adjust all of these to be the right-hand versions. And I also want to increase the speed a little bit. Let's bump this up to 5. And let's try this out. There we go. So you see both of the controllers are being tracked now. I can move them separately. It wasn't even taking into account the right-hand controller, so weird. Preset, I think they'll fix that in a later point. So you can notice that I can move around and move up onto these things here. And if I actually select the XR rig, you can see the character controller. You see how the actual character controller isn't moving when I move my head or when I stand up or turn. So we need to go in and adjust that. And I've come up with a workaround. I'll show you guys that real quick. If we look into the character controller driver's code, we can see when it actually updates the character controller. And all we want to do is make it update every single update. We want it to re-update the character controller's position because the head-mounted display is always going to be moving. It's dynamic. So if we scroll down to the update character controller, this is the method that we want to copy. We don't actually want to change it here because this is code that is controlled by Unity and it could be modified in the future. So the workaround right now is to go into the XR rig and we're going to add a new script and we're just going to call this character movement helper. Inside of this new class, we want to paste the method that we copied from the character controller driver. And we're going to want to call that method every time there's an update. And we're also going to need to add all of these variables. I'm going to rename them without the M and we just need to make each of them up here. So we want an XR rig. We want a character controller, a min height and a max height. The min height and max height we can actually get from the character controller driver. So for these, I want to say driver min height and driver max height. That way we don't get confused by having two different min heights and max heights. And inside of the start method, we just need to instantiate each of these. Make sure to save all of this. And then let's go back into Unity and run it. And you can see the character controller now is dynamically adjusting to where we move and the height. Perfect. So now if I walk up the stairs and then slide over to the side, it will adjust me accordingly and it won't think that I'm still up on the ledge even though I've fallen off. So a lot of these little edge cases this fixes here and also has the added bonus of me not being able to push into the wall. There you have it. Let me know in the comments if this works for you, if this was a good step-by-step breakdown of how to actually do the VR movement, and let me know what improvements you made. If this was useful to you at all, if you used any of the code, please give me a like on the video. It really helps me out and, you know, the algorithm. In future videos, I'm going to talk about how to do teleportation, how to do climbing, zero G movement, maybe some Spider-Man type swinging, grappling hooks, all that kind of stuff. So please subscribe if you are interested in more VR content. And as usual, I am super active in the comments section. So if you run into any specific issues or bugs or something you can't understand, just drop a comment and I will respond in probably less than an hour. So until next video, just find me in the comments.